Good morning, students. In the last class, we have done the unit number 2, that is prose and poem. So we have done with the unit number 2, which we have done the explanation and the grammar part. So now we will be doing of unit number 3, prose. The topic is how do bees make honey. So what is the topic? How do bees make honey? So this is an activity. Look at the pictures and their descriptions, match them. So by seeing the description, you have to match the correct with the correct pictures. So these are the description and these are the pictures. You have to match them. You have to draw the line towards them. So only four pictures, four descriptions are given. You have to do it in your textbook. So now students, let's read the lesson on honey making. While reading, find the answers for the following questions. So while reading, you have to find out the answers for these questions. So what is the question? What is honey used for? Where do bees collect nectar from? So let's read the paragraph. Honey is the oldest sweet used by people. It is a natural sugar made by bees. It contains sugar, proteins, iron, and calcium. We can digest honey very easily. It calms cough, soothes a sore throat. It is also known for its ability to kill bacteria. So honey is here, you can see. So honey is the oldest sweet used by people, and which kills the bacteria. We can use it for cold, cough, and when you are having the throat infection. So that time you can use, which kills the bacteria. So the honey contains sugar, proteins, and iron, calcium. Okay. So now let's read the next paragraph. Let us learn about making honey. Honey making is not very simple. Honey bees start the honey making process by visiting flowers and collecting nectar. They gather nectar in the spring when most of flowers and plants are in the bloom. They use their long tube-like tongues to suck the nectar out of the flowers. So while doing the honey making of honey, so let us learn about making honey. So honey is not very simple. We can't make it very simple. And honeybees start honey making process by visiting what? Flowers, collecting nectar. So when they suck in their tube-like in tongues the nectar from out of the flower. So like this they make a honey. So students, you can see in the picture also the bees are sucking from the flowers. Next, they store the nectar in their stomach, honey sacs, and carry it in the beehive. While inside the bee's stomach for about half an hour, the nectar mixes with the proteins and enzymes produced by the bees. The nectar is thus converted into honey. The bee then drop the honey into the honeycombs, hexagonal cells made of wax produced by the bees. The bees repeat the process until the combs are full. So here students, they store the nectar in the stomach and carry into the beehive. Where they will carry? They will carry into the beehive. While inside the bee's stomach for about half an hour. The nectar mixes with the proteins and enzymes produced by the bees. Enzymes produced by the bees. So the nectar is then thus converted. So the nectar is converted into honey. The bees then drop the honey into honeycombs. So after converting into honey, the bees drop into the honeycombs. And the bees repeat the process until the combs are full. Until the combs are full, the bees will be repeating. So here you can see the meaning of nectar. A sweet fluid produced by the flowers and made into honey by bees. In bloom, with the flowers fully open. What is the meaning of bloom? With the flowers fully open. The flower will open, right? So that is called bloom. Next, honey sac. Also called honey stomach. It's an honey stomach hive. So it's a bee hive, a structure where bees live and make honey. So enzymes, chemical substance that is produced. So it's a chemical substance that is produced. So next, students, to prepare for long-term storage, the bee fan their wings to evaporate and thicken the honey. Note, nectar has 80% water and honey has only about 14 to 18% of water. So nectar has 18% of water and honey has only about 14 to 18% of water. When this is done, the bees cap the bee comb with wax and move on to the next empty comb. So in the nutshell, the honey we eat is nectar that honeybees have collected, regurgitated and dehydrated to enhance its nutritional properties. So here, to prepare for long-term storage, for preparing a long-term storage, the bees fan their wings. They fan their wings to evaporate, thicken and honey. Note, the nectar has 80% of water and honey has only about 14 to 18% of water. When this is done, so the bee cap the bee comb with wax and move on to the next empty comb. They will move on to the next empty comb. So in a nutshell, the honey when teeth is a nectar that honeybees have collected, regurgitated and dehydrated to enhance its nutritional properties. Here you can see the meanings. Fan, make air move around. Fan is nothing but make air move around. Evaporate, turn from liquid to vapor. Evaporate is turn from liquid to vapor. Honeycomb, a block of wax full of six-sided holes in which bees store honey. So honeycomb is nothing but a block of wax full of six-sided holes in which bees store honey. Next is hexagonal, having six sides. Wax is smooth substance made by bees to steal the honey filled cells. So next para, honey bees are divided as a house bees and field bees. The house bees keep the houses clean and well ventilated. They build new combs to store honey. Field bees are older bees. They go away from the house. Their job is to search for nectar. So here you can see the honeybees are divided into two. That is house bees and field bees. Okay. What does the house bees do? The house bees do. They clean the houses and well ventilated. And they'll keep it very neat. They'll clean. And they build the new combs to store honey. They build new combs to store honey. But field bees are older bees. They are older bees. They go away from the home, that is house. They search. Their job is to search for nectar. Okay. So the next is regurgitate. Bring food that you have already swallowed back into your mouth, which is already swallowed. You have to get into your mouth. So dehydrate, remove the water from something. You have to remove the water from something. Ventilate is admit fresh air, the fresh air. Okay. So next is honey. Bees do not live long. At the time of honey gathering season, they work very hard. As a result, honey bee does not live longer than a month. Around 2,000 bees die every day in a honey-making hive. The queen bee lays eggs and she maintains the population of hive. So here you can see honeybees do not live long. So they won't stay long. And at the time of honey gathering season, they work very hard. The honeybees work very hard at the time of gathering the season. As a result, honeybee does not live longer than a month. The honeybees does not live longer than a month. They won't live longer than a month. Around 2,000 bees dies every day. So 2,000 bees dies every day, every single day. So 2,000 honeybees will die. The queen bee lays eggs and she maintains the population. The queen, the honeybee, the queen will be there, no? So the queen bee lays eggs and she maintains the population of the hive. Okay. So this is your chapter which we have done. So the next will be your question and answers we will be discussing. And before starting the lesson, there were two questions. So that we'll be discussing in the live session. Okay. So thank you, students.